There we go. Not really sure. Oh, there he is. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Just melt away. Kabloom. Welcome, everyone. This is Javita, and thank you for joining us today. We are playing No Man's Sky Survival Mode. As you probably can guess, we're inside of the anomaly. We are actually back in the, I believe the previous episode, I showed you all that I can now use the base teleporter to go to two different systems. This is the red system that had the anomaly. And it appears that I could practically visit this anomaly over and over and get new things to do here. Or, you know, the next conversation, I guess. So, you, friend, visit the worst places you can find. Stay alive. No good to me dead, are you? Can't learn much from a corpse. Although, dots. No, never mind, stay alive. Okay. At last, Polo is agreeable once again. A nod, a smile, even a compassionate tap on the arm at one point. A friendship renewed. I blush when the Gek mechanic tells me that they hope I live a long, healthy life, but have to swallow disappointment when it transpires that Polo's true motivation for this is to study how my suit responds to long-term exposure to extreme clients. Transmit survival data. Okay, here you go. Sentinel-made replica. Oh, there we go. Okay. Nice. It's not as important as it once was, but it's still nice to have. Let's see here. We're gonna need, yeah, copper. We have everything else. We have some, but not enough. Not that much copper. Okay. Well, oh yeah, we can talk to the priest entity. Nada. Red orbs dominate, hostile. Creators or their relics. Singularities are king. Peripatetic path to the galactic core. Path message from creator or sloppy workmanship? Okay. Making as much sense as always, apparently. Nada's paranoia is infectious. I find myself spying into the room before I enter. The Gek Polo seems occupied, taking joy in their chores, but Nada's shell is static save for the dancing lights. Was that a flash of red behind the visor? If it was, it doesn't repeat. I wait a moment and enter loudly. Polo greets me effusively, but Nada and I are standoffish, our trust failing. We haven't seen an Atlas in a while, so. That night, he seems to keep giving me the same tech over and over. Well, I think to verify this notion that I have, I think I'll poke my head right outside and come back in and see if all this stuff resets, and then if that doesn't work, maybe go back to our planetary base and then come back. Anyway, until then, welcome back. So just going in and out really didn't work, so this is returning to my base and coming back. Well, here we go. Full galaxy for you. Just for you. You must see it all. No, I joke. A few more systems, maybe? With our earlier awkwardness now long forgotten, Polo greets me with a gentle wave and beckons me over. They seem even more excited than usual, which turns out to be because they wish me to indulge in their favorite hobby, unfettered exploration of the stars. Warping is the apex of galactic travel. To reach a new system is a prize unto itself. Polo earnestly hopes that I will do more of this and discover places they have never dreamed of. Transmit warp data. Okay. Warp reactor tau? No. It is new technology, at least. It's just not really technology I care for. Okay. It's the multi-tool. Any... that looks like the same. Yeah. And... ooh. Hello. Hello. Not as boycotting me, I guess. There was something about mistrust. Maybe he just really doesn't trust me anymore. But also, I don't know. I can't imagine this being an intended mechanic. So, interesting. Well, I think I'll try it one more time, and just to kind of see what happens. I'll be back. Okay, round three. Brand new creatures in every world. Easy, easy for my friend. Finding all that one world has, not so easy, maybe. Ooh. We actually can't turn this one in. Okay. Polo is oddly muted this time. At first I worry I have caused offense again, but the Geck gestures forlornly at a jumble of broken electronics beside them. It seems that an accident has befallen some of Polo's precious research. Aww. Polo ushers me out the door apologetically. I know how dear the Geck's data was to them and yearn to help. Perhaps when I next return, I can restock their archives with reports on multiple strange creatures. So we need planet zoology scanned level 1 or above. Nice. Well, not really, but that means I have to go spend some quality time with a particular planet. Actually, I probably ought to do that with my home planet, because I should have just about everything. I'm kind of surprised I don't. And Nada is still not talking to us. I don't know. It's the same icky looking thing. Okay, well. That actually gives us kind of something to do. Been a little kind of unsure what to do, considering all of our specialists are now eye candy. In other words, we have nothing more to learn from any of our specialists. Apparently not without becoming a scientist ourselves, or breaking international treaties, or, you know. So, I guess we can go look around on our home planet and see if we can't find whatever missing life forms. So, until then. Well, alright, let's see what this pirate thing is going to be all about. Ooh, we need carbon. Oops, that didn't help anything. Oh well. Not off to a good start, but... well, yeah, it was a pretty pathetic. I don't think they actually even damaged our ship. So much for that attack. Okay, well, I'll meet you on our home planet and see if we can't find whatever creatures are missing. Welcome back, everyone. We are on our home planet, base, whatever you want to call it. This planet Rugs of Fusi? Yeah, maybe I should rename that, except yeah, I've already uploaded it, so I guess I can't rename it. But anyway, this is where you can upload your discoveries. If you're somehow unfamiliar, these red dots mean they have not been uploaded. So you can upload creatures and basically anything you've scanned, even places you visited. So, But the other side of it is, at least for the animals, here's this big long list of things. And once you complete this list, you can then upload kind of like a batch of it for another reward beyond uploading the individual stuff. So it looks like we're missing three things. I really don't know how that's possible, but yeah, apparently it is. So I think the first thing I'm going to do is a trick I heard about a long time ago. But I'm going to get rid of the sentinels. But yeah, the basic premise is you fight the sentinels until a walker comes, you kill the walker, and then for whatever reason, once you kill the walker, sentinels no longer bug you. So I think I'll get some sentinels rather unhappy with me. Takes a little bit of time, so I'm not gonna bore you all with that. So I'll be back probably just before the walker comes. Okay, so I'll show you this a little bit. The basic premise is you want to keep them aggroed to you. When that bar fills up over their head, just like that, then they call in reinforcements, and their considered threat level escalates. So we just got the quad walker, whatever you want to call it. Oh, I need to keep him alive. And yeah, melt away. And then it's just kind of rinse and repeat. We just wait for the bar to fill up, try not to take too much unnecessary damage. Gets progressively slower. So be back when the walker gets here. Okay, the guy's starting to call in. There we go. Not really sure. Oh, there he is. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Just melt away. Kabloom. That was easy. My blaster's OP. Oh. It's like a fire hose. Okay. I mean, up at the top, you can see it looks like I still have full hate from the sentinels. Oh, wow. Okay. Already know it, but no other sentinels actually come, so here we go. The one downside to this is just now we're stuck listening to combat music for the rest of our stay on this planet. This does reset after you leave the planet, so just keep that in mind if you're doing this. So we got three life forms to find. I'm just gonna guess that, yeah, one of them's gonna be flying, and probably the other two are gonna be in the ocean. Okay, well, I think I'm gonna go hunt around for a while and see you then. Okay, I thought I'd just show you all this. Yeah, there we go. So off in the distance there, I can't tell if we scanned them already, but those little dots are something that's alive. If they're closer, it'll be green or red. Green being, that we've scanned, red being that we have not scanned them yet. Okay, well, we just swam practically across the ocean to find stuff we've already scanned. So that kind of sucked. But there is Rigogen. Okay, finally occurred to me that, duh, there's caves too. It's actually one of my least favorite critters. These kind of brain spider crab things. Mainly because, as far as I can tell, they're pretty much always hostile. So, yeah. And so yeah, just one more to go. Still not really sure where it's going to be. I mean, unless there's another cave dweller, which it's actually kind of hard to find deep caves on this planet, so I might try to explore the caves a little bit more. So, until then, welcome back. After hours, I finally found the last one. At least I hope it's the last one. Yeah. Yeah, I finally left orbit to basically get on the other side of the planet, so that reset the sentinels. Where did he go? Come on, you can hit me, I don't care. There we go. Guess I could have just killed it and then scanned it. Okay. So hopefully. No! Okay, there's still something else to be scanned. That's not fair. Okay, well, I've just about decided that I might just go to a brand new planet and to do this. Maybe one with copper on it, because we need copper. Oops. Okay, well, whatever I decide, I'll see you on the other side. Welcome back. I gave up on my home plan on trying to find all the life forms, and so I jumped planet, went to a new system, and was just kind of exploring around and went to a manufacturing facility and found this. It had something to do with the Korvac studying me, and so I opened up a line of communication, and this is what they gave me. So yeah, awesome. This is the first time ever having one of these. We don't even have the second one, just went apparently straight to the third. So let's see here. Exosuit, there we go. And yeah. In dire need of some inventory management here. There we go. Da 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 da. Okay. Is that any of the silly doors around here? Maybe. Ooh, here we go. It only takes version 2. Cool. Very planty. Oh, okay. So we can. Of course, we can get carbon anywhere. What else? First aid, isotope. Really? Okay. Well, that's a bit of a letdown. Okay. Well, I'm on this particular planet. I'm kind of back into the same situation as I was at the last planet. I'm down to two life forms, and I can't seem to find them anywhere. I haven't found anything in the caves or the air or the skies, so I'm guessing that's where they're going to be. But I've been through the caves, and I certainly haven't seen anything flying around. But so. Well, okay. I guess I'll go back to hunting. Until then. Okay, finally. This little thing just kind of, he ran up and bit me in the butt, quite literally. Killed him, and turns out he was the last thing I needed to scan. So, now I can finally upload this. This needs to be like, 3 or 4 million for as big of a pain in the butt it is. Not, it's about like 200,000, I believe. So, I think we'll go to the anomaly and see if this was worth it. Meet you there. Oh, another quick quirk is apparently the Atlas Pass version 3 works for the version 2 locks, but not the version 1 locks. So, I don't know what's up with that. Welcome back, everyone. Just made it back to the anomaly. Let's see what all this hard work has gotten us. Brand new creatures. Yes, we've already read this. So transmit data. With infectious enthusiasm. Yeah. Ooh, nice. I was wondering how I was gonna get the next level of this. I had the first one for quite some time. Ooh, 150. Oh, the both the rare silica and titanium. Cryosinite. Oh well. What else am I gonna do with it? We can fly! For a while. Yeah, I guess that's longer. Oh, he's actually talking to us now. Polo, joy in experience. Only data valuable slash joy. Nada tried. Nada tied to shell to this galaxy. Frustration slash sadness. You. Not tied. Key, explore, escape, report back. they talk so weird. Nada and Polo are unusually quiet. Polo is elbow deep in machinery, Nada in simulations. But the room is tense. It is clear that there has been a recent disagreement. Nada beckons me over. They express frustration over being tied to a machine body, but I am different, able to survive in so many ways, in so many places. I can go anywhere in this galaxy, be it in search of truth, or to live my life as I see fit. Nada envies me, they admit. Let's hear. So, he seems to be giving me the same shield boost Sigma, and we already know half to the Atlas, so I guess we can do a shortcut. Okay. Pretty straightforward. He wants carbon, so I'm almost afraid to see what they want me to do next. How far is the Atlas? I think the other system my portal goes to, I'm only one jump away. Yes. That we already. Oh, okay, it's for the black hole. Wow, the black hole's only one jump away? Seriously? Yeah. That's not what we're really after. So, yeah, that's a way off. Okay, so what we can do is hop in the space station, go to our base, and then hop to the other space station where it's only one jump. So, I guess I will meet you there. Okay, just found this ship, in the space station. It's 33 slots, so we're gaining about 4 slots, and the cool thing is that it's got both the Sigma and Tau warp reactors, and they're side by side, so they'll link. About the only way they could get any better is if you could somehow get the hyperdrive over there with them, but I think I'm going to go ahead and do this upgrade, because yeah. Yeah, I guess I could save my money to get an even bigger ship, but for now, yeah, we can make money pretty easily, so, nice. Okay, well, I will meet you at the Atlas interface. Welcome back, everyone.
Dun dun dun.
Ta-da. Ooh, it's black this time. Let's see here. I think this is only the second one we visited this playthrough. I've been very distracted with base building and specialists and black holes. Let's see here. Required. Ooh. Stamina. Let's see, we already knew that. Trying to think. Yeah, I think we've only gone through one black hole. Yay! Free fuel. Nexus. Yeah, I'm not even gonna try. Okay, what do we got here? Okay, so. Another Atlas interface. How many of these constructs exist in the deep void? How long have they been slumbering, waiting for a traveler? Have they been waiting for me? Am I somehow chosen? I sense the creators of this reality. They emulate everything. The Gek and the Viking, the Korvac and the Sentinels. Every world that turns and from that lives. The ghost of them lingers and drives me on. There's so much I can learn from them. Yeah, we can't understand any of that. So what happens if we refuse? let's find out. I deny this path. I am no one's tool. This journey is something. Wow, okay. Figured it was just kind of like, okay, goodbye, you can talk to me again anytime you want. I think this will be a good enough stopping spot. Next episode, maybe we'll go to the black hole and do, we got some pretty good hyperdrive going on here, so we could make some serious distance. Do some serious traveling, or maybe go do some more stuff for Polo and Nada. So, something along those lines. Anyway, this was Javita. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like these. And if there's anything you didn't like, please let me know down in the comments. Until next time, peace.